This episode of French Class has been brought to you by Sacado Backpacks. Sacado Backpacks, where you go when you know. All right, people, I want to talk to you a little bit about why class goes the way it goes and the science behind how come we teach French this way here at West Sullivan Middle School and Spanish. But you're more concerned with French because you're in French class. So I want to talk to you a little bit about a science called linguistics. Now, the science of linguistics, anybody ever heard of the science of linguistics?
Yes.
The science of linguistics comes from the same word in French as the word for tongue. The word for tongue in French is langue. And the word langue can also mean language. Because, well, it comes from the same word as language. I mean, if you look at that, it looks like the word language. The word language comes from the same word for tongue, because you can't really talk a language unless you're using your mouth and your tongue. Also, has anybody ever heard the expression, like, your mother tongue? Yeah. Sometimes people say that for your language that you speak at home, your mother tongue. The science of linguistics comes from this word, langue, which means tongue in French, or language, and it's basically the science of how we learn how to talk in another language. Also, how languages are put together, and kind of like the rules, and how languages change over the course of time. So, the science of linguistics has discovered a lot of things about how people actually get the ability to communicate in a language. And they have found out that there's two different kinds of ways to sort of study or work on getting a language. You can either learn it, like with your brain, or you can acquire it. And I want to tell you about why when you're acquiring it, you're like learning it more with your heart, and it's actually a better way for you to study a language because it makes it where you can actually use the language. So long ago, they didn't know anything about this kind of learning or this kind of like studying the language. All they knew about was how to learn it with your brain. So like when I was a student, when I first started taking French back in like 1991,
back in my day,
we just learned the rules. And we studied like lists of rules and list of words, and we studied out of the textbook. So we learned all these rules, such as this. I'll tell you a rule in French. In English, we can put this at the end of a word, like the dog's house, and we can say that the house belongs to the dog, and we use this right here, apostrophe S. Sometimes S apostrophe, I don't know, it gets kind of complicated. In French, we cannot do that. French doesn't use an apostrophe S, it uses a different rule. So if you said the house, the dog's house, you would actually have to say the house, la maison, of the dog. Du chien. And then this du actually means of and the. Because of is de, and le is the, and if you put these together, it makes du. So that's the way I learned French. I learned it with my brain, right? They would teach us these rules, and then we would have to do all these practice exercises in the book. And we were supposed to be learning how to talk the language and how to put it together based on the rules. However,
sixth grade.
Oh yeah.
I hate sixth grade.
Yeah, I also hate Tanner. I saw him calls and I'm like, no, he's alive.
So
why are the sixth grades so short?
We were
they're still growing.
It's so small.
So, when I started taking French, this is how people thought. This was back in the 90s. Most teachers, like probably 99.9% of teachers, mostly taught by learning the rules. Right? So you would study the rules in the textbook, you would practice the rules, and you would learn that if you have de plus le, it goes for du, and you can have apostrophe s, and then when you're trying to talk, you had to like figure out all the rules for what you wanted to say. But then, I decided that I wanted to teach French, because I really liked learning French. and I went to France after high school. And I had this experience that made me know that I wanted to find a different way to teach. I didn't know there was a different way, but here's what happened to me. I was a really good student in French class. My teacher told me, "You're the kind of student that you wait for years and years to get because you're such a good French student. It's so much fun to teach you. You're so good at learning all the rules and memorizing all the lists of words, and you're just so great." And I was like, "Yay, I know French really good." Now math, different story. But French, I was like, "Yay, I'm really good." So then I go to France, and I was thinking, "Yay, I'm gonna be able to make all kinds of friends. I'll be able to make all kinds of really cool friends in France, and I'll have friends for life, and it'll be great." And then I get to France, and I wasn't able to just kind of talk without like having to think about all the rules, because I'd learned it with my brain, right? So every time I wanted to say something, I'd be all like, "Okay, what's the rule? What do I say?" And there was like some people that I didn't really get to like be friends with because I couldn't really talk to them because I knew all the rules, but I wasn't able to like just kind of from my heart just kind of talk. So there was this kid named Xavier. Xavier was really funny. He was really smart. He was very athletic, and he was kind of cute. And so when I met Xavier, I was like, "Hey, I kind of like this kid, Xavier." But every time I try to talk to Xavier, in English, I'm kind of like naturally funny, right? So I was like, "I'll go tell Xavier a joke. He'll like that." But every time I tried to open my mouth, nothing would really come out of like my heart. Like I wasn't able to just kind of talk from the way I would in English. So I would be thinking about all the rules and everything. And by the time I came up with something funny or cool to say to Xavier, he'd be bored, right? Because he's like, "What's this girl trying to say?" I mean, she's just like standing there like thinking of the rules. And he would move on. And guess what? By the end of the summer, Xavier was dating my host sister, Floor.
Floor?
Shoot to kill.
Floor?
Shoot to kill.
Did you kill her?
He was dating the Floor?
Her name was Floor. It was Flower.
I love you.
So, I realized at that moment when I saw him and Floor, my host sister, going off to have a good time together, that I needed to find a way to help my students be able to make friends when they needed to make friends. Yes, dear. So, I did some research and I did some studying and I figured out like what science actually says about trying to get people to be able to speak, like open up their heart and talk. And what I learned is that what we basically want to do is to be able to talk and not have to use our brain, just be able to kind of talk from the heart and not have to think. Like right now, I'm talking to you in English, and I'm thinking about like, what do I want the kids to know? But I'm not thinking about like all the rules and everything and like all the rules about how to talk in English. I can just think about the message, the lesson, what I want you to hear, and I don't have to think about all the rules. So later on, when you've learned enough French, you know, we'll tackle some of the rules and stuff. But this is what I want to get you guys to first. So this was the goal, right? This is every teacher's goal. So what do you have to do to make people be able to talk without having to think about the rules so that they can just like talk from their heart and actually be themselves in the language and not have to be like, how do I say that? What do I say? Basically, there's two things that go on in language. You put in something and you get out something. So what you put in is called input.
Output.
And then what comes out is called output. Yeah, it's just like a computer. And basically, the good news is all you have to do is listen and read input, and you don't even, it's so amazing. It's just like when you're a little baby. Your parents don't hand you the rules, a textbook, a bunch of flashcards, a list, and say, "Time for you to learn English," or whatever language you studied at home, or
you can
speak
at home.
They literally just gave you input. They would talk to you, and they talked to you in a way that you understood. So they'd be like, "Do you want to play with blocks, or do you want to play with a truck?
Truck.
Blocks, or the truck.
Truck?"
And then you talk back to them, and they make sure that they're showing you what the language means, and you're understanding. So basically, your parents would just talk to you. So you'd just be listening to your parents.
A train.
And then now that you're older and you know how to read, we can actually also read in French.
Also read.
So if we just listen to things that we understand, and we just read things that we understand, it's like almost a magical process. That's why I love teaching languages. It's like you don't even have to work at it. It just happens like by magic, just like it did when you were a little kid. You listen to enough, you read enough, and eventually you're able to talk and write. Writing usually comes before talking. In fact, this is the order they come in. First you listen, then you read, then you write. Not for babies, but for older people.
I'm like, how do you write enough? Jesus.
Your parents are like, can you just please write that down, young man? You're like, Baba, write that down. All right, turn and tell somebody what you just learned. Go. Give a question.
The way the steps to learning French are first you have to listen, then you have to read, then you have to write, then you have to talk. That is the best way to learn.
I feel like
I can write some
logic.
It's the listen to read.
I thought talking came by writing.
How do you
talk?
You just
kind of
all the time, then you would just probably learn like
I thought talking came before writing. Buonissimo!
French is very similar. I might actually start on this.
It's obvious.
I took French first in college. I took Italian, and then I took Spanish, and they're all all right, kids, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. The first time this has happened, people.
Oh, no, it is. Oh no.
Oh well, maybe you'll make them go. Can
you miss Melanie's right under here. She likes it very quiet and organized and
It was amazing.
Well, we're not gonna do that because last year she got really, 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 really sad about it. So I don't know.
She got angry.
Well, angry, sad, what?
She, like, came running up here and started, like...
It was funny.
I remember that day, and I don't want it to happen again, so I'm going to try to be quieter.
I was in her class.
I can't wait to have that party.
Hey, kids, maybe these things will go away. Who knows? All right, so we've just learned a lot about how come in this class I do a lot of talking and you do a lot of listening. We learned about why I decided that I need to find a better way to teach because I want you to get some abilities in the language so that if you want to make a friend or a significant other, then you can go and do that.
What is this?
And now I want to tell you a little bit about how you are graded in this class, okay? So, there's different types of grades that happen. I'm just going to wait until everybody's watching because I just want to make sure that we're all ready to go. This is very important, so I'm just going to wait for everybody to be watching up here. Thank you. Okay, so I want to tell you about your grades in the first term and then later in the year because they change a little bit. Because the first term, you know, number one is just listening, right? So in the very first term, there's two different parts to your grade, and they're all based on listening, because that's the first thing that starts to happen for you when you're acquiring a language. Just like it says on that poster over there. First, we learn to listen. So, in this class, you've got two different kinds of grades. One is 65% of your grade, and one is 35% of your grade. And they're both listening, okay? The 65% is based on what you do in class. That means that, like, when we're talking in French, you're paying attention to the conversation, you're participating in the conversation, and, like, if I ask you, like, is today Monday or Tuesday, you're able to say Tuesday, right? So that I can tell that you're understanding what's going on. Well, I mean, just for the sake of argument. 35% is based on, like, little quizzes that we'll take over what we heard in class, okay? So I think we did this the other day.
Yeah,
I sat in the back and I asked you this or that, right?
Yeah, yes.
Sometimes we will do that on a piece of paper. And you'll turn that in for a grade, and that'll be 35% of your grade. So that's the first term. It's all just listening. That's how we all start out. Then, later in the second term, and third and fourth term of the year, we start doing some other things. I'm gonna grab a different color. Let's say blue, which in French is bleu. Actually, this marker is dead, which in French is mort. It sounds a lot like murder.
Okay.
Yeah, more. Let me put this in the trap. French is la belle.
Can I please put it in the trap?
Go in the rocky jar.
Is that 65% start counting now?
Well, now that you know about it, I think I'll tell you about it tomorrow, how I grade you, but it's pretty easy. All you gotta do is listen, show me that you understand, participate in the discussion. Pretty easy. That's about it. In fact, I think I've told you now. All right, people. Next term, and the term after that. So the first term ends like sometime in the fall. And then we're gonna start doing reading and writing. Now remember, reading and writing don't happen first, they happen second and third. So they're gonna be pretty late in the year, like in about 6-8 weeks. Reading, you're gonna get graded not on, so we're just gonna have like reading time, right? Anybody have reading time in language arts ever where you just get a book and read it? Okay. So I have tons of different kinds of books, and you'll just get to pick whatever kind of book you like to read. I have little baby books, like literally ABC books. I have magazines, I have all kinds of stuff. And so you're not gonna be graded, because everybody's different as a reader. You won't be graded on like what you read or like being able to write like questions about it or anything like that. You're just gonna be graded on your habits as a reader. That means that you're trying different books until you find one that you like, that you pick a little stack of books and make sure that you have plenty to read, that you're staying put, not wandering around, focusing on your reading, all that good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Then when we get to writing, we will also just be graded on your habits as a writer.
Yay!
A lot of people, well, I would say every kid develops as a writer at a different pace. Some people, like maybe this is you, when we sit down and do our first writing sometime in October, you might be able to write like a whole page. I've seen kids do it. Other kids can only write a little bit. So why is it fair, if you're trying your best and you're listening really good, for me to say that you have to write a whole page, or you have to like spell everything, or you have to know all the rules? You're just getting started, kids. Your spelling's probably gonna be horrible. You don't know all the rules yet. But if you listen really well, you'll be surprised. You might actually be able to write half a page to a page. Kids are always really surprised when we sit down to write for that first time. So you'll also just be graded on your habits as a writer. That means that you're trying your best, you are focused on your writing, and that every time you're just getting a little bit better because you're pushing yourself as a writer and you're focused on your writing. You're not going to get graded on talking in this class because you're a beginner, and they've done studies on kids, and they have decided that talking in front of the class is the number one anxiety-producing thing in a foreign language. Raise your hand if you would like to get up and talk in front of the class. If you do, then let me know. We'll make opportunities for you to do that. But most people would rather just listen and read and maybe do a little bit of writing later in the year. And then when they feel more comfortable, confident, they'll be able to speak. Now, of course, I'm not going to stop you from speaking. I mean, it says limit English. It doesn't say limit French. If you want to talk or try talking with me in French, you please go right ahead. I'm not going to stop you, but I'm not going to make it part of your grade. This class is part of a 2-year sequence, 7th grade and 8th grade, and you get high school credit for it. So basically, in 2 years, you can get high school credit for 1 year of high school. So that means that there's really no hurry, right? We have 2 years to do what they do in 1 year of high school. So we'll work on this, like, second part of 8th grade. That'll be something that we do later. Because right now, I just want you to start with the basics, listening, reading, and writing. Turn and tell somebody near you what you have now just learned about your grades.
Listening.
5 5